Guys, welcome to Pen Dentistry. Hope you are doing good. I am Dr. Aishwarya with you for easy learning and better understanding. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please go and subscribe to my channel and learn the dentistry in an easy manner. Today we are going to see about the jug handle view of X-ray. Jug handle view. What is jug handle view? Here what happens that the X-ray you are going to take is extraoral. Extraoral means from the outside the mouth you are going to take the X-ray from the outside the oral cavity. For the zygomatic arch view, to view the zygomatic arch which are present on both the side of the skull, as you can see in the picture, zygomatic arch. For the zygomatic arch view, we do this jug handle X-ray. It is a modified view of submentovertebrate vertex view. How you are going to place the film? The film position. The film position you are going to place it. The cassette will be placed perpendicular to the floor. Okay, this is the cassette. It will be placed perpendicular to the floor. In a cassette, there is a cassette holding device. This is the cassette holding device here. Floor in a cassette holding device. Okay, you are going to place the cassette. This is the cassette. For the position of the patient, the head is centered on the cassette. The head will be centered on the cassette. This is the cassette. You are going to place the head in the center of the cassette and the neck tipped backward. The neck will be tipped, if this is the neck, and you are going to place it little bit neck backward. This is the face. This is the head. This is the vortex of the skull. It will going to touch the cassette. It will going to touch the cassette. There will be no space present here. The cassette and the skull will be touching each other. Okay. Both the mid-sagittal plane should be perpendicular to the plane of the film. The mid-sagittal plane. This is the mid-sagittal plane. It will be perpendicular. It will be like this. It will be like this. That is, it will be perpendicular to the film. The central rays, the cone is brought close. As you can see, the cone will be brought close to the, this is the skull part, and your cone will be brought close to it. Okay. The cone will be brought close to it like this. And it will be perpendicular to the film. It will be perpendicular to the film. This is the perpendicular direction of the source. From here, the X-ray rays will pass and it will hit the cassette and the film. Indications of the jug handle view X-ray is that where you can use this jug handle X-ray. Okay. When there is a fracture of the skull, at that time you are going to use it. When there is a frontal sinus investigation, you want to investigate the sinus, and calcification in intracranial region. If there is a presence of calcification or occurrence of calcification in the intracranial region, at that time you will use the jug handle view X-ray. Next, it is disease affecting cranium. The disease in Paget's disease, in hyperparathyroidism, in multiple myeloma, in these diseases, you are going to use the jug handle view X-ray for the investigation purpose. Okay. So these are the indications of the jug handle view X-rays. The trick which you are going to use here for the remembrance of the jug handle view X-ray, that is jug. Jug is similar to zygomatic. The G and G is present in both the letter word. So this is the trick you are going to use, jug zygomatic. Jug and zyg, both are z z. So jug and zygomatic. This thing you will put in your mind for the remembrance of the jug handle X-ray view. Okay, so this was the trick here. If you like the video and understood well, please subscribe and share this video to your friends and your batchmates for easy learning and better understanding. Keep watching Penn Dentistry. Learning structures seen in the jug handle X-ray. Rest of the things which you can see rather than the skull, the or zygomatic arch view, you are going to see the base of the skull, the condyle position and its orientation. The sphenoid sinus will be seen, the lateral pterygoid plate view of medial and the lateral side is seen, medial and lateral pterygoid plate is seen, foramina at the base of the skull, maxillary sinus, lateral valves, maxillary sinus, lateral valves of maxillary sinus is seen, curvatures of inferior border of mandible, inferior border of mandible, the curvatures will be seen. These are the rest of the things which you can see in the jug handle view of X-ray with the zygomatic arch or submento vertex view.